Hi, I'm Vern Bastian and welcome to this instructional video from MetroCount, where we'll show you how to install a typical pair of road tubes for a vehicle classification survey. Before we get started, it's important to note that none of what we're showing you today is to replace any local standard for safety. There's no recommendations as to exactly how you should operate safely in the field. That's really down to your training and to your workplace. We've selected a location that is very free of traffic. It's in a developing suburban area just by the coast in sunny Western Australia here. And we're going to get very, very little traffic, hence you won't see much in the way of traffic control. But normally you will need an appropriate level of traffic control. You may also require somebody to be working with you, and there may be specific rules for working in isolation. So safety, as always, is paramount, and don't do anything if safety is ever compromised. Well, here we have an array of the various tools and hardware you're going to need to conduct the MetroCount traffic survey. We have tools that are used for the installation and the actual MetroCount equipment you're going to need for the survey. So let me show you that in a little bit more detail. Here we have a MetroCount roadside unit. You'll need your MetroCount roadside unit to have a fresh battery or sufficient battery charge to last the expected duration of the survey, and the software will give you plenty of warnings. We also have a standard 30 metre roll of road tube fresh from the factory, and I'll show you how to prepare that. We have a 20 metre roll of bitumen tape. We won't use much of this today. We'll just use this for additional securing of the hoses as required. Okay, so here we have a padlock and MetroCount stainless steel security strop. You could use a chain if you wish. Other MetroCount equipment we supply include the MetroCount vent plugs for securing the end of the hose. We supply the standard road nails, specially designed for traffic surveys, the figure eight cleats, and the centerline flaps for securing the hoses. Other things I've included today are some stainless steel washers, which I'll use with the nails just to make them a bit easier to use. We also have a tape measure, heavy-duty utility knife, some side cutters, which can be handy, lumber crayon for marking the road if required. One of the most important tools you'll spend some time selecting will be your heavy-duty mallet for installing the road nails. You should select a mallet that is good quality and is comfortable and suits your style. To remove the road nails, you're going to need a heavy-duty crowbar, and select one that's got a reasonable length so that you can use it without kneeling too much on the road. For measuring the tube spacing, you can use a tape measure, but I've prepared this aluminium bar, which is slightly less than the 1 metre that I need. And that's been calibrated to allow for the diameter of the road tube, so that when once installed, we've got an exact metre spacing. I've got some cloth tape, coloured yellow, which is handy for use with the bitumen tape, and I'll show you that when we do the installation. I've got myself a set of knee pads because we'll be doing a lot of kneeling on the road. Also have a propane torch, a gas torch here. That's just simply used to prepare the bitumen tape on colder days. Okay, let's get into the tube prep.